hands on deck. It's a battle royal to be in things tonight here in Buckhead. Up to the Royal Event Center here in Buckhead, Georgia. For Veda and Coco, and the participants start to slowly trickle out of the back, and there's plenty of them stocked in the GCW locker room. Kevin Hensley, GCW commissioner, with you tonight from Buckhead. Very privileged to be bringing you a victory for Veda and Coco, a benefit show for some very loyal fans on the Georgia independent wrestling scene. Eight huge matches, including this one tonight, in store for you guys here on the GCW YouTube channel. It states the winner of this one will be number one contender. As you see Leatherface pop out with that Poland chainsaw. Yikes. He sharpened the blade recently. Nice. Anyhow, number one contendership for the GCW heavyweight title is up for grabs. Brandon Cage out here. Incoming talent, of course, here in the GCW locker room. We're always very, very privileged to be bringing in the newest stars from all of you great Georgia Championship Wrestling fans as we turn 30. Tonight's show is the 3-year anniversary of the resurrection of Georgia Championship Wrestling. Leatherface is practically clearing the ring here. And drawing a lot of fan support, surprisingly, for the big man from the Badlands of Texas. I think everyone's ready. Leatherface puts the chainsaw away. We got Pillsbury Doughboy Eddie Honcho on the floor. He's finally in the ring. Bell sounds and we are off and going, and smart tactic by everyone involved in this. They're all going after the monster, and well, nobody dropped him. He just dropped them all himself here in Buckhead. Leatherface cleaning house all by his lonesome here tonight. Overhand club by Leatherface as the action pairs off into three different corners. Six-man battle royals begin things tonight here in Buckhead. And I'm being joined by our special commentating partner tonight, Ben Masters. Thank you, Ben, for joining us here.
Hey, great to be here. Great night, man. Some great action lined up tonight for Georgia Championship Wrestling. I'm excited to be here.
Absolutely. It is our privilege to have you with us. And what we're doing tonight, of course, a benefit show for one of the biggest fans in the state, as you well know, Ben.
She really is. You know, Veda and Coco are all over Georgia. They go to every show, I think, that is available. And they have friends all across Georgia. So those friends are reaching back out tonight, helping them out.
They're somewhere every weekend, no doubt about it. And I think Eddie Honcho's forgotten the rules of a battle royal. He tried a pinfall. And, well, that's not going to cut it in this type of matchup. Big stakes, though. Winner gets the GCW heavyweight title bout down the road.
You know, it's hard. It's hard. You know, all these guys want to be champion. There's more money and more fame. And sometimes it's hard to climb that ladder. This is the shortcut up the ladder.
A lot of people think that winner's purse is just make-believe. It's the legit thing, my friend.
Yeah.
If you're at the top of the card, you get more money in that wallet every week. You can't beat that.
And why else would you be working, right?
And Leatherface throws out one of the combatants, so we're down to five. And I don't know why on earth Eddie Honcho thinks he can tag in now. He's not really taking this too seriously. Shot at the top title in the promotion, and now he's back in the ring, teeing off. And delivers and a bit of embarrassment.
Another elimination over the top rope.
And that's another one. We're down to four. Brendan Cage, who has been fighting through the singles ranks here in front of us. Eddie Honcho tossed out, and is he gone?
He is. He's a little dizzy, I think, when he came out.
And I don't think he's going to stop until he gets to the locker room. He's headed back.
Hard body slam.
We're down to three, and Brendan Cage is in trouble.
Choke slam.
Leatherface is just going off here in this bout and making short work of all the challengers.
Over the top rope down.
And over goes another.
Down to the floor.
And we're down to two. We're going to see a brass knuckle championship match tonight. We're going to see the Anarchy Championship defended as well in our main event. So a stacked card tonight, to say the very least. A lot in store for all of you great GCW fans on our YouTube channel.
And we got some legends in the house tonight. I'm excited. Everybody here is happy to be
absolutely
here.
Great to see some of the people that are here. And it's over. Just like that, Leatherface disposes of five other men quickly to win this battle royal.
And Leatherface will get that championship match. He could be the next champion for all we know.
And you see, he's telling the crowd he's going for it next. We'll have to see if we can get that match made for our May show.
And it remains to be seen what will happen in that match.
It does. I find it hard to believe how little he goes off his feet, if anyone can actually defeat him, or he may be our new heavyweight champion. We'll be back in just a moment. About as we're back with you from Buckhead for GCW's a victory for Veda and Coco. Well, Leatherface made quick work of everyone, so I guess we need to tone it down a little bit now to a one-on-one matchup and that monstrosity of a matchup to begin things tonight. Six-way confusion, as I call it, because there's too many moving parts in the Battle Royal.
Really, it was.
Now we got a number one contender for our heavyweight title. Pee-wee just popped out of the curtain. A little late to the party. Good job, Pee-wee.
He's probably still excited from watching that battle royal. But this man right here has made a fast name for himself.
No doubt about it. Dave Stage in the house with us tonight. And looks like his opponent's going to come in and thwart things. And if I'm bringing out some pops, I'm getting the heck out of the ring. Dave Stage and Nikki Hyde here one-on-one in Buckhead. And Nikki Hyde coming out like a thief in the night and getting the upper hand a little sneakily, Ben.
Absolutely. Not wasting any time. Realizing what he's up against, Dave Stage is no slouch. Trying to get that early advantage in the match for sure.
Yeah, I definitely got the size disadvantage working against him, so he's getting the early pounce, a lot of forearms from the right side of Stage's face, but that was not a smart maneuver. He's not going to shoulder block Mr. Stage to the ground. And look at the power of this man. One-handed, Ben.
Right.
With ease.
Man. Just drops him like a sack of potatoes.
And you can feel that shake, the very foundation of our Got to Be Rolling Event Center, where we hold our cards each month. Well, Hyde's momentum's gone, to say the very least.
Man, just throws him around like he's nothing.
Belly to belly. And now for lateral press. Referee a little slow to get there and only got a two count, but it's early. We'll give Nicky Hyde some credit. He might have kicked out either way. See that super loud Stevie Ray Vaughan skulking around ringside too.
Yeah. That's the advantage too that he does have.
Nicky Hyde with a good leapfrog to avoid disaster there. Now gets a head of steam running uppercut to Dave Stage. Northern Lights float over. Stayed hooked into a belly-to-belly of his own and barely got about a one-and-a-half count. Hyde not happy with the referee's count there, excuse me.
That was three.
Now choking him on the rope here. He's got that towel out. Referee not seeing it, being distracted.
That was two.
by Nicky Hyde.
What is it that, I mean, I don't understand why Vaughn is always around and causing trouble. I don't know. I've had a hard time seeing his value, but he apparently impresses enough clients to keep a job, so there's that.
Well, I think that probably Nicky Hyde realized that he needs an advantage over a man this strong.
Nicky Hyde tried a quick roll up there, didn't he get a count that time?
Boot to the back now of Dave Stage, and Hyde continues to work on this man.
Measuring him here, taking a little time to flaunt to the crowd. Measuring him as he slowly climbs to his feet. Drop kick didn't even take him down. He looks petrified. And tried a dragon whip, and that didn't even work.
Man, look for a sliding drop kick.
Drop kick to the knee?
Attacking the bottom lower legs now, Dave Stage. You take the table legs out, the table will fall.
That's exactly right. Hyde whips him in, and Stage again just mows him over. Oh, my. Hyde's strategy not working too well here in the middle part of this bout.
And the powerhouse, Dave Stage, pulls it back up. Rides him out for a hard chop to the chest. He's going to feel that next week.
Absolutely. That's not a 24-hour healing right there. That's about a 120.
And another hard chop by Dave Stage.
Slap some meat here tonight in Buckhead. Stage with three thunderous chops. How in the world's Hyde still on his feet after that, quite frankly? Don't quite know. He's worked him all around the ring.
Yes.
Driving that massive frame into the midsection of Nicky Hyde. Suplex. Oh,
holds
nice.
Him up. All that power and strength of Dave Stage being displayed right here.
Nicky Hyde's boot just about the lights here.
Got to hit the light.
And just dropped him, measured him. You know all that blood just flows straight to Hyde's head. He's going to have a hard time getting up.
A lot of blunt force there on that drop. And he's feeling the worst of it right now. He's dizzy. He's disoriented. And he's in a world of pain.
And a big spear from Dave Stage. I believe that's going to be all she wrote, fans.
That's it. It's all over, and your winner is Dave Stage.
Well, Stevie Ray Vaughan can sit there and fan Nicky Hyde all he wants. It's going to take a moment for Mr. Hyde to convalesce and get out of the ring. Dave Stage with a big win here in Georgia Championship Wrestling. More action coming your way when we come back from Buckhead. Back with you from Buckhead for GCW's victory for Veda and Coco. You're watching us here on our exclusive YouTube channel. Make sure you click the subscribe button and you'll get notified each time we upload one of our shows. Mr. Kevin Hensley alongside Ben Masters here tonight in Buckhead.
Happy to be here. Great crowd, great matches, legends, top Georgia stars. Everything's going right here in Buckhead tonight.
And out of the back comes Damian Bennett. Skulking around ringside as the crowd's trying to just figure out what to make of Bennett. And we've seen him several times here at GCW, a talented athlete, to say the very least.
Outstanding wrestler he is.
Shut your mouth. Now Bennett's jawing with some of the fans at ringside over here to our left.
Man, making idle threats here as he gets in the ring.
Well, not endearing himself to the crowd, and I don't think he really cares. Damian Bennett. Still drawing with the fans. We've got security somewhere in this facility. They may be over there taking photos with Thunderbolt Patterson right now, I'm not sure.
I wouldn't doubt that. One in a lifetime opportunity to see the legend.
Yeah, why would you not? I mean, he's here. Come on.
And a lot of people didn't expect him to be here. Great surprise you pulled there.
Well, he confirmed it about 5 hours before the show. So nice to be able to bring anyone that we can here to this great audience in Buckhead.
I'm glad he's not pointing at me.
I thought he was for a minute.
Well, he might be. I haven't seen him in a while.
Do you owe him money or something?
I was just wondering. I was trying to remember. Do I owe him anything?
Any outstanding debts, maybe?
If he starts coming over this way, I might just let you handle the debt.
Well, if I have to, I'll have to whip out my singles. And
save one for the team.
Well, I do that enough each month here in Buckhead, that's for sure. Dirt Road Dynasty keeps me on my toes. Well, eventually, fans will have an opponent pop out to maybe silence David Bennett for a moment.
And it looks like the Wild Man.
It's Jungle Boy making his way out. How about that?
Young Mighty Joe making his way to the ring. And this man, unorthodox, I've seen him at several Georgia towns. Hard to understand what he talks.
I'm not sure that he knows where he's at, but
I don't think he does.
He's found his way to ringside, so that's a good start.
He certainly got a tough chest ahead of him, and Damian Bennett, but like I say, this young man has been all over Georgia, so it's interesting to see. And you don't know what he's going to do, is the thing with him.
The Young Mighty Joe and Damian Bennett one-on-one. Bennett has stepped out of the ring. He's trying to figure out what to make of this young man as well.
Looks like you stepped right out of the woods into the ring.
I was going to ask you, since you know a little bit about this man, where is he from? Do we know his origins?
All I know is he's from the woods in Savannah, Georgia.
The woods? That's a vast area in Savannah, Georgia, for sure.
And he's biting the rope now. I wouldn't want to put my mouth on the ring rope.
Well, especially since COVID, but I digress. Young Mighty Joe squared off with the ref
and attacked by Damian Bennett right here at the bell. Trying to get himself together, and he may not realize what a tough competitor he's in the ring with right now.
Young Mighty Joe is going to take a young mighty whacking here in the early going. Big knife head chop by the GOAT, Damian Bennett. Rally behind the mystery man from the woods of Savannah. I understand it.
A lot of times they do the monkey chants and some of the bullets he goes to. Every now and then you get a word you think you understand, but most of the time, just ooh, ooh, ooh. That's all you understand.
I see.
And he didn't know how to move out of the way.
Big splash. Does
and
not
he's
work
going
out.
Up to, oh, got him with the legs.
He's running.
And now he's going in.
Takeover. Monkey flips.
Speaking of monkeys.
Yes.
The monkey flips him.
Well.
And he goes down hard and out of the ring he goes.
I will say I didn't have to do much negotiating with Young Mighty Joe to get him here to GCW. I actually went to an interpreter, but I didn't realize it was going to be this kind of an athlete. And he is impressing.
Well, I think he has a handler that takes him around and tries to guide him to the right places. And I'm always wondering if this handler's going to show up at ringside one day.
Well, Bennett's trying to gather his bearings after that quick surge from Young Mighty Joe.
Moving in with a lot more caution, right? Test the strength.
How about a test the strength
behind
in 2024? How about that, Bennett? Just the upper hand. I'd say Bennett's got, 60 pounds probably on the shot man?
At least 60 pounds. Hey, Bulldog.
Ooh.
So he's been doing his homework. Well, I don't know if they have cable in the woods, but He's watched somebody.
Bennett is asking for a timeout. There is no such thing in this sport.
Oh, that was a hard blunt shot.
They're battling right above us here, and I don't like it one bit, Ben. I don't know how.
These people in the front row are getting their money's worth.
Well, they jawed and jawed.
Wow, a headbutt.
There you go.
By young Mighty Joe, and now caught him. Ow, on the apron.
Hardest part of the ring. We have to remind everyone once a show of that, I think.
That'll slow him down for sure. He might need an extra banana for breakfast tomorrow.
Now Ben is giving these fans that were giving him such a hard time in his introduction a glaring stare. And they're being pretty quiet. Probably a smart move.
That had to hurt.
Joe Damian Bennett getting up on his arm.
Not going to play with this young man.
He goes down with the cover, hooks the leg, and he gets two.
Only a two count.
This
should be a submission. I don't know if he understands submission. Does he know? I know sometimes he gets confused about the counts.
Well, it may just be a primitive instinct to tap at some point. We'll see. Maybe not. I see Joe trying to fight his hand off.
Or maybe he could just pass out. I don't know.
Bennett is cinching, wrenching.
This is where that extra size is coming in handy for Damian Bennett.
Crowd starting to rally behind young Mighty Joe here in Buckhead. Joe's having a hard time finding his way out of this hold, though.
Hard to breathe when you're tied up like that, you know?
And that rolled him into the ropes.
He's got the rope, and I don't know if he did that just by grabbing, or if he knows that's going to break the hold.
Mighty Joe, very thankful to be out of that grip.
Hard, full body slam.
Huge.
Damian Bennett now is taking it down to business. And going to the top rope.
He's going to maybe go upstairs here.
Going to fly now, I think.
Now that Rocky song's in my head. Thank you, Ben. Off the top comes Bennett.
He moved.
And Bennett saw it.
If you move.
Telegraphed it. Quick breather.
Right.
Running elbow.
Jones, comes up.
Comes up with a running clothesline.
This man's got a second win here. Flying drop kick. He got a high.
Boy, he was in the lights there.
One,
the leg.
Two. He got it.
No, he
no,
got
so
two.
Close.
Got the shoulder up.
Two and three quarters. So close, but so far away.
And Mighty Joe is not going to give up on this momentum.
He's going to the well one more time.
Got to get it while the getting's good, as they say. Off the top. Yeah. And misses the splash.
Overplanned at that time, and now that knee is going to be hurt.
Caught him. Knee on the mat.
Picks him up from behind. Shoots him in. And he's got it.
Spine buster.
And that big should be all she wrote for the
devastating spine buster. And that is it.
Great matchup here at Georgia Championship Wrestling, and your winner is Damian Bennett, and I think he had more fight than he thought he was going to get in this match.
Young Mighty Joe put up a valiant effort, but Damian Bennett, the GOAT, picks up the win here in Buckhead. We'll be back in just a moment with more singles action. A couple of stars you've seen before. It'll be fateful Alexander Lev against Georgia Groan, Scott Mason.
Looking forward to that one for sure.
Ben, as we come back to you from Buckhead, I just got one question. Are you faithful to Alexander Lev?
You know, I met Alexander Lev when he started in Georgia, and he has come a long way, but faithful, I don't know if I can do that.
Well, I promise you he's going to ask as he makes his way around ringside. He asks me every show.
I will say he has come a long, long way.
So much raw potential in this young man. He has superstar written all over him. Here comes Lev, circling around ringside, greeting the fans rudely here in Buckhead, and they're greeting him in response in kind.
The feeling, I think, is mutual.
Yes. I don't think any Christmas cards will be exchanged between anyone here in attendance and Mr. Lev this year. Lev has worked with the NWA already in his young career, so building quite the resume for himself. Still in his early 20s.
And of course, he would love to put another feather in his cap right here tonight.
He's going to have to go through he says he's Georgia grown for a reason. He is Georgia tough as well. And here we go. It's question time.
My name is Alexander Lamb.
Okay. Well, we knew that, right?
But are you? Well, no survey tonight. He's telling everyone he's faithful. Fair enough.
So he's faithful to us. Is that what he's saying?
I get the gut feeling this young man is only faithful to himself. He just kind of oozes that arrogance.
The word narcissism comes to mind.
Quickly, I might add. Here in the opening licks to bring in Scott Mason.
Scott Mason, an outstanding athlete, all his own, and a good straight-up fighter. I enjoy watching Scott's match.
Mason had a blood feud with Hunter James last year when James was still our GCW heavyweight champion.
Right.
And it went through tables, it went through no disqualification matches, it went through a bevy of stipulations. And Scott Mason brings the crowd to their feet here in Buckhead.
Scott Mason, and he's a big man.
Very big man, about 6'4", 6'5", right around that 260 mark. Rugged, knows his way around the ring. And Alexander Lev knows his way out of the ring. Smart move.
And Lev is now sitting this debate at the lady that we're doing the event for. I'm sure
and
she Lev, is entertained.
Thought about trying to sneak up on Mason. That's not a good move. Mason was ready. Referee Matthew Daniel will call for the bell when things are organized.
Well, don't underestimate Scott Mason at all. Don't take him for granted.
No, definitely not. And Lev knows that. Let's be clear. He's trying to play mind games with Scott Mason. I don't think that's going to work. Lev taking his sweet time getting back in the ring. And Lev right back out as the bell sounds. And what's he going to do? Make Mason come to him? Lev's threatening to leave.
Right.
He went through a lot of trouble to come out here and introduce himself to the crowd if he's just going to turn around and walk off.
Absolutely.
But again, it's mind games. Mason's in no hurry. He gets paid either way. He doesn't care. But you know he's going to take apart Lev once he gets in the ring for making him wait.
Absolutely.
Daniel admonishing Alexander Lev for the stalling. And maybe finally we'll get some action here in this bout. Hot Scott Mason, I didn't take long. An elbow tie-up. Lev trying to gain some leverage going down to his knee. That's not going to work. Mason's going to out-muscle him any day of the week in this one, fans.
He might have to try a different plan of attacks if he wants to out-maneuver this man, Scott Mason. Psychological warfare now will probably come into play.
Absolutely, Lev is going to once again pretend to get in and out of the ring. I suppose he does. He's back in now. There we go. We use the man in the striped shirt. That's not a good idea either.
Not at all.
Interference with Matthew Daniel. Quick fist bump with the senior official here in GCW. That's the second test of strength we've seen challenged here tonight, Dan.
Absolutely.
Scott Mason's height on full display here.
Yeah, that's kind of a bad idea there if he takes this test of strength because the advantage.
Oh,
how
about
that's
that?
A headlock. Smart thinking there by Webb, for sure.
Webb might have dropped a loogie as he did so. Off the rope, big shoulder tackle. Winner, Scott Mason. No surprise there. Webb is really milking that 8 and 9 count rule that you have in professional wrestling. He's went to the floor after every bit of contact and so far has yet to get the upper hand in any form or fashion.
Right. Now moving in cautiously, locking hands, and now he grabs his own side headlock.
Hey, well, it's good for the goose, it's good for the gander.
He's at that height advantage. Go for the hair.
And that's one thing that Scott Mason does not work against him. It's a lot of hair you can grab onto if you're one of the opponents.
And Lev doesn't mind taking those shortcuts.
How about a short jab to the kisser? That woke Scott Mason up. Uppercut in the corner.
And a hard cutting chop to the chest of Mason. Full arm twist now.
He dunks a second one. Look out.
And oh! Retaliation by Scott Mason.
Overhand chop. Yikes, that can collapse a rib in a hurry.
Now, trying to set him up for another shot.
Hey, he's going to get the fans what they're asking for. That's a backhand. Wow.
Yow. Man, that hand came from way across town.
Keep it open. Here comes Mason. Stops.
And a hard
and
chop.
Just chopped him again. You know what? I thought he was going for a splash there, and he threw everybody off. And low bridge by Alexander Lev.
Desperation move by Lev.
You gotta do what you gotta do to cut the big man down to size, though.
Absolutely. And you wrestle a man that big, you gotta have thoughts before you get in the ring. You gotta have a game plan, an idea. What can I do to attack this man and bring him down?
Here, chin lock pops up and just starts grabbing at the nose. It looks like a clump of Mason's hair is stuck to Lev's trunks. On top of his bout.
This is what happens when you're not faithful.
Camera taking you right in there as Lev just chokes, blatantly chokes Mason in front of the referee.
Wow.
And Mason is trying to convalesce in the corner. Won't get much of a reprieve as Lev just arrogantly rubbing the boot across Mason's face.
None of you people are worthy.
Here comes Mason, trying to fire back off his, and he's up to a lateral base. As soon as he is, Lev's just gonna chop him right back down. He's got him weakened right now. Strike while the iron's hot. Mason's having a hard time recouping here, man.
He really is. Every time he gets him on that rope, he cuts off that air supply. I don't care how big you are, if you can't breathe, you can't move. And he is wearing this big man down, little by little. Tosses him out now to the floor.
And out to the floor. Oh, boy, you thought that Mason's a big man to go to the floor.
It's a hardwood floor, and there's no padding down there.
I mean, fans, this is a skating rink. Let's just be honest, when there's a lot of wrestling rinks in the middle of it, so there's no gear. The hardwood floor on top of concrete.
He shot the third when they slam him on the wood. He's up against that post now. Another hard chop. Taking a lot out of the big man, Mason. I think he's trying to motion you over there.
I'll stay where I'm at.
Oh! Now that time he overestimated himself.
That's a solid steel post. Just to be clear.
Ooh, hard cutting job.
A jam of finger, leaves some tingling. Mason firing back. This
out of the eyes there.
I gotta be honest, senior official Matthew Daniel being very lenient here, just letting these men go around the perimeter of the ring without administering a count. I like it. I'm not gonna lie, I like it. Lev back in the ring now. Mason greets him.
He is fighting back, but Lev is coming on strong now.
once again, Mason on his knees, almost as tall as Lev standing up. Big height.
Covers him lateral press.
Didn't hook the leg, though. That's one of those things that Lev's going to have to pick up on as he goes through his career. Any time you go down, you got to hook.
Especially a big man like that, he's not going to be easy to beat.
Chances of pinfalls like that are few and far between. Going to make everyone count. He's clubbing across the chest of Scott Mason and has it all knotted up. And using his own arms to choke him.
He is locking him up now with a knee to the back and coming behind the man and almost into a choke here.
That's compressing.
The ref has to watch that very carefully.
That's compressing the windpipe quickly. Scott Mason's lungs have got to be closed. Way he's compromised.
And he's still there trying to get the fans, so they're rallying their support now. Sometimes that extra support is all you need.
That's exactly right. Three big elbows.
Off the rope.
And left elbow.
Now we have it yet. Still did not hook the leg.
Hooked the leg. Come on, Alexander.
He may be a little bit too cocky. It should be have self-confidence, but not too much.
That is no question Mr. Lev's downfall. He may be a bit too cocky at times on the second rope. Well, he asked the crowd if they were faithful. I think it's about a 50-50 split. He's off clothesline.
Off the ropes and come on. He got the leg. He might have it.
And he got a two count.
Oh, so close.
That was three. That was two.
One of the fans yelling from ringside, that was three, and Alexander Lev pleading his case to the ref in kind. Mason still battling to get up. A lot of fight left in that man.
Wild match going on here. Back and forth. This match should go either way.
Break across the face by Lev.
And he's staying on him. That's one good thing that he has picked up. You cannot give any surcease when you're attacking a man this size. He's hitting with everything he's got.
He is. And an uppercut again. Lev's just, I gotta be honest with you, he's spending so much time trying to take Scott Mason out. He may be exhausting himself here.
No! Hard punch!
Mason's back alive. It's a.
And now they're trading blows.
Seesaw battle here. Jab. Big overhand right. And who's going to come out on top here? Lev standing his ground. I'll give him credit. Hey, Georgia Grove Scott Mason's not going to give it up, though.
Oh!
Double clothesline. Neither man goes down. Off again. Double
stagger.
Shoulder block. Both their heads cracked.
Both men out hard to the floor.
And both men on the floor.
And whoever gets up first will have the advantage, obviously.
Whoever gets up first may win. After that, that was a thwack of two noggins. Here in Buckhead, Mason over to our left. Lev right in front of us.
No doubt they're both seeing stars right now.
Down to five. Daniel taking his time on the count to give these guys a moment to convalesce, but it may not be enough. Seven, that's eight. Then they may not make it, buddy. They're both back in at nine.
Barely able to make it. Oh, clothesline left. Hits that apron and down to the floor he goes. And that apron's hard too as well.
No doubt about it. We saw that in the last match. Young Mighty Joe took a devastating crash and burn on that apron.
Head first into that apron.
Lev knocked silly as he collapses in front of the fans here in Buckhead. Battle still on the outside.
There's no give on that apron. You just deal with the pain. Look at there. Once again, head right into the apron.
Mason holding Lev up so he can hammer away at him. Lev getting some body shots in. They're not having much effect.
He blocks it that time and throws his head down.
Mason gets
good thinking by Lev. And now look, he's getting violent.
Lev's drawn a chair out. I don't know where in the world did he get a chair from. That ring was empty when I was here. It was later, they were sitting it up.
This was for you, man.
He must have snuck that chair out later on.
I'm sure he did. He probably came here really early.
I am the
your Messiah.
He's got Mason sitting down. He's going to run the perimeter of the ring to get momentum before he clotheslines Scott Mason, who moves.
And he goes down.
Man, that steel chair did not end up turning out very well for Alexander Lev. The fateful one is hurting. Scott Mason is struggling. And the fans here in Buckhead can't get enough of it. Count at seven again. And he runs Mason into the ring post and sneaks in.
And first,
that's it. How about that? Lev with a sneaky maneuver gets the win by countout.
What a way to win a match, but he got the win in it nonetheless.
Lev's going to get his hand raised here. How about that?
This young man is smarter than the average bear. He got the win this time over Scott Mason. But what a battle this was.
Indeed. And Mason's still on the floor.
Your ass hurt?
He got ran head first into that steel post. Lev with just a great leverage maneuver, pardon the pun, picks up the victory. We'll be right back, fans. More to come, including the landmark Heritage champion Jacob Ashworth in action after the break. We're back, fans. Welcome back to Buckhead. Kevin Hensley and Ben Masters with you for Georgia Championship Wrestling. A victory for Veda and Coco. And hold my beer, Hanson, that is his name, has made his way out. Much to the delight of those in attendance here in Buckhead. Thunderbolt seems to be a hit tonight, Jim.
He really is. Hall of Famer for 2024.
Gave a great speech.
It was a long time coming.
Absolutely great speech a few weeks ago.
He paved the way for a lot of wrestlers.
No doubt about it. A lot of wrestlers followed themselves after.
Well, Dusty Rhodes, I worked with him a long time. He admitted I got a lot of my stuff from Thunderbolt Patterson. He just always had that charisma, you know?
Absolutely. Infectious charisma. And we got another Hall of Famer here in just a few bouts. If you stay with us, fans, one half of the Rock and Roll Express, Robert Gibson, is
still looking good.
Still looks like he's going there and win a world title tomorrow. Terry Oliver, watch out. And it sounds like the music of our landmark Heritage champion, Jacob Ashworth, is broken out across the Got to Be Rolling Event Center here in Buckhead.
Hold my beer, Hanson. Got a tough challenge tonight.
Wearing his finest denim vest up here above us. Jacob Ashworth, one of the crowd favorites. Ashworth greeting Jason Blackman in the crowd here tonight. A lot of dignitaries on hand this afternoon here in Buckhead for a big show. Ashworth greeting his fans as he makes his rounds. Non-title bout, I might add. It's going to be a tough challenge. There's going to be a lot of beef in the ring here in just a moment. Hold my beer, Hanson on one side and the pride of Royston, Georgia, Jacob Ashworth on the other.
Get that championship belt in hand.
Brass Knuckles title up for grabs still to come. That's actually our next bout. As we mentioned, Hall of Famer Robert Gibson in action. Excuse me. Anarchy Championship will be defended here tonight as well. That's a big match for GCW to bring.
It's a loaded card from top to bottom.
Can't beat it. This is the place to be.
If you haven't seen Georgia Championship Wrestling live, you need to get out.
Absolutely. No question about it. I invite folks every month. It's at 1200 Shivers Avenue, Chivers, here in Buckhead, Georgia. No, not that Buckhead. We're about an hour outside Atlanta, but still.
She likes me more.
And join us for
nice sports arena here for sure. Absolutely. Great wrestling atmosphere.
It's big enough for the ring and the crowd, and it's still compact enough to feel like a big show, and it is for sure a wonderful facility. Great atmosphere here tonight in Buckhead as well. Bell sounds, and this one is off and running.
Are you ready for this, GCW?
Beer Hansen trying to discourage Jacob Ashworth from stopping. He's got a little smirk on his face. And I guess we got the posturing out of the way. Here we go. These two bulls walk up center ring. Hansen stomped on his foot, gained the upper hand. Well, last word there.
Caught him with that blunt elbow.
Doesn't even know if he's in Buckhead, Georgia, or Atlanta, Georgia right now, or Augusta, for that matter. Hammering that head into the turnbuckle. Hanson rocked. Heritage champion drives that 265-pound frame into the abdomen area.
And showing why he is the champion.
No doubt about it. On that belt.
He moved the whole ring.
On that belt in Hardcore Hell 25 in Kenton, Georgia last September. And how about the big man going off his feet for a drop kick? How about that, Ben?
Absolutely. You get a man right here that's standing toe-to-toe with him, but he is giving him no way. He's going to try to take a shortcut and take the advantage here. You got to cut Jacob Ashworth off, or he's going to just finish this match.
And Ashworth trying to escape that chokehold. Hanson caught him on the low bridge on the middle rope. Hanson, a heavyweight, so to speak, but don't take any away from Ashworth. He's about 265. And Hanson's got the upper hand, however, right now here in the corner, clubbing away. Still trying to gather his bearings after that early flurry from Ashworth.
One, two.
Ashworth crumples on the mat. And both men exchanging blows. Well, I'll say this for the two combatants in the ring, they're very talented, but you can't see a matchup like this and think you're going to have a catch-as-catch-can classic.
No way at all.
That's for sure. Ben, if you have much experience watching Cole Bobbier Hansen over the years?
I have, you know. I've seen him in the tag team, I've seen him in singles, and very different wrestler, you know, old country boy. But those country boys, they come up knowing how to fight tonight.
Absolutely. Country grown, for sure.
But I'm pretty sure Jacob Ashworth's a country boy, too. So.
No question.
You know that old song, the country boy will survive, but which ones don't survive is the question.
Ashworth flips out of the way, rolls up, Hanson gets two.
Got him with that man.
Doubles him over. And he is writhing in pain right now.
Gasping for air. Yeah. And with this packed house in here tonight, there's not a lot to go around, I'll be honest with you.
And as a champion, you know, even if you don't have a title match, you have a lot to lose anytime you wrestle a man, because they're coming after that title at some point. That's what it's all about, that fame and that money.
Blows being administered to the back by Hanson. Keep Ashworth off his feet. Ground and pound here. There's a double axe handle sledge right across the spine. Set up here, maybe coming off with a splash. Nope, just another running sledge. And now mocking the crowd. I wonder if Ashworth actually hearing that, or if he's just instinctively doing it as a reflex. He's hurting right now for sure. Well, the comments of Holt My Beer Hanson are not reflective of us here at GCW. The last horse shirt, I think, is actually pretty nice. I like that color of blue.
Not a very good reaction to the crowd. The crowd does not care a whole lot for Hanson, for sure.
Second rope, Hanson measuring him. Big man's going to come off. He's taking a lot of time. And
oh, my!
Holy cow!
All that weight came crashing down.
Oh! I'd have snapped a 2x10 under the ring.
Elbow hard.
Here comes Ashworth. Sidewalk slam. And another thunderous spot on the mat.
Ashworth reminds me of a young Stan Hansen. You know, Stan just throw people around.
Absolutely. Got him up in a fireman's carry. That's a lot of man to have up there. Hansen escapes. Charges. Ashworth got him. Full Nelson. And he may be going for a...
Ow!
Oh, my goodness.
Lay down.
Slammed him face first. Hansen's not getting up from that.
That's all she wrote for sure.
Big win for the Landmark Heritage Champion, Jacob Ashworth. Ashworth will emerge from this slugfest, this battle of the bulls, so to speak, tonight here in Buckhead. Up next, fans, the GCW Brass Knuckle Championship is on the line.
What a fight that's going
to
be.
Eddie Honcho and D Money promised to, I'm sure, work the entire floor of this arena in the quest for the Brass Knuckles title. We'll be right back.
Thank you, Buckhead. Thank you.
Batten down the hatches. Ben, it is Brass Knuckles title time here in Buckhead.
You know, Brass Knuckles matches are not known to be scientific wrestling matches, so you're liable to see some stood-up fighting.
But this one should be a little bit of fun because of this challenger that we're going to have emerge in just a moment. Eddie Honcho, a crowd favorite for sure.
Eddie's always ready for a party, isn't he? Edible Eddie Honcho. How about the Skittles?
Edible is debatable, but I digress.
Does he weigh like 20 or 30 bags of Skittles?
I think it's about 30 bags of Skittles.
Yeah.
He looks like he's up to 31 right now. He's not hearing anything from the crowd.
Well, he's trying to get the crowd.
There we go.
And he would like to walk out as the Brass Knuckles champion for sure.
The Eddie Chan has already began as the Pillsbury Playboy makes his way to ringside here in Buckhead. The champion, by the way, D Money, we'll be seeing him emerge here in just a moment. Coming off a title defense last month, a successful one against Madman Pondo, the deathmatch legend. Well, those two duped it out and pulled out all the stops. You can catch that bout right here on our YouTube page at the in the video called The Battle at Old Buckhead. That was our main event last month. And even today, before the show started, we caught an errant thumbtack that was still jabbed into the mat from that bout 1 month ago. So
dangerous tight matches for sure. Those kind of matches are not for the weak at heart.
Definitely not. And then I think you and I probably should keep our heads on a swivel here tonight with this one on tap.
Well, you go that way and I'll go this way.
Fair enough.
Find your local exit, nearest exit.
These chairs will fold if we have to pack up pretty quick. Champ about to make his way out. The pride of Detroit, Michigan.
What a character he is indeed.
Say the least.
A lot of personality in this match.
It's going to be an interesting clash of personalities, though.
Truly is.
Money decked out in his finest green apparel.
Right.
already drawing the adulation of the crowd here in Buckhead. Bringing out the pops, stoically waiting to give the introductions here at this championship bout. It's odd to say this, but this is only one of two championship matches. We normally have a lot of belts on the line here. Not the case tonight. And that money bag, I'm sure, is stuffed with some kind of a goodie. And we'll go to Pops now for the ring introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is for one ball in this Quarterpass Knuckles Championship. Introducing first, the challenger. He hails from Kearney, USA. He weighs in six bags of jumbo skills. He is the heavyweight of the world, Ivanhoe Hunter!
And by the way, fans, the math on that, five bags of small skittles equals one jumbo, so about 30, as we said earlier. That, the math works out.
Not bad now, baby.
I think he added a bag.
Well, he might. He might have.
Nothing funny about the money, he said.
Well, we'll see how that plays out in this bout. Got to remember, it's a title match either way. And Pee-wee is already having to cover up D-Money's ears. I hope he'll sanitize his hands later after that. Yikes. Brass Knuckles title up for grabs. Pee-wee showed it off to the crowd. Beautiful belt. Once held by Steve the Brawler Lawler.
Talked about legends in Georgia.
No question about it.
Steve Lawler actually started out with me, so we went way back. And I mean, I was getting in when he was in.
Pee-wee signals and we are off and running. E-Money's just taking in the Pillsbury Playboy, and here's the thing, if no action takes place, this could go on for a while, fans. I'll just be honest with you. Bell sounded, we do have a match underway, technically. That's strength, maybe?
Oh, he wants that.
Maybe a posing contest? Maybe let's have a Skittles eating contest.
You know, if we break out the sour Skittles, I would actually pay to watch their faces as they talk.
How about Skittles on a pole match?
Skittles on a pole is a stipulation that we'll have to have next month. And, well, they're breaking it down. I hear some funky music somewhere in the background, and D-Money fell for it, hook, line, and sinker. That's not funny, says not funny money, D-Money. Say that five times. Serious. That's going to be hard to do, but Honcho knows what he's doing in that ring for sure. He's trying to get in the head of D-Money, and it's working. Title is on the line. Cinches the armbar.
He's getting the ire up for sure of D-Money.
D-Money's,
you know, that anger management might be important. If he loses his temper, he could lose more than just this match.
D-Money was the unorthodox tag team partner of our now number one contender, Leatherface, for many months here in GCW. Those two made an interesting item, but they were successful until D-Money won the Brass Knuckles Championship in Macon, Georgia, back in September. Right now he's a little worse for the wear, got tripped off his feet. Now Honcho meets him halfway with a headlock. First wrestling move of the match, I believe. Well, yes. Second one, I should say. That armbar did count as one, I suppose.
Come on!
Referee Pee-wee is really just in a count of three count. You got to remember, fans, Brass Knuckles, it can get violent in a hurry. And the referee's only there to declare a winner. Anything goes. Reversal hip toss. D-Money slammed hard to the mat. Honcho owning the upper part of this match. Quick jabs. Still hammering away. D-Money is taking a shellacking in the corner. Honcho winds up and hits him in the belly and in the head. Yikes. D-Money's sitting a little prone right now. That's the word we'll use. And Honcho is backing it up for that patented stink face, and D-Money takes a powder. Not baby powder either. Honcho was out of steam.
No!
Oh, my.
Right into that steel pole.
The ring shifted about 4 inches on that move. Holy cow.
No giving that post.
Nothing funny about D-Money's money, says D-Money.
Nothing funny about that ring post either.
Now the ring post will always win, and he's got, I believe that's the wrench they use to tighten the turnbuckles.
I don't think it was meant for this use, but
definitely it's not. It's hey, it's legal. It's as legal as a wrist lock in this match. And you're enjoying it in 4K, all the brutality here on GCW's YouTube channel. I hope you're enjoying tonight's broadcast. Honcho hooked hard over that bottom rope.
And wrenching now on that arm.
That elbow could pop out of place easily at that kind of a angle, but Honcho breaks free and now takes the upper hand. He's got to stop backing money up against the post, though. That has already backfired once. The open hand slap, D-Money fights back.
In a match like this, you pretty much know in advance someone's going to get hurt at some point.
They always have medics on standby in case that does happen. And Pee-wee felt that. He's having to adjust to make sure it wasn't him. D-Money can deliver a hell of a chop, and we just heard it.
Ow!
And the ring posted too.
I felt that.
I think D-Money's hand may be shattered. Uh-oh.
We're just talking about being injured, right?
Well, Honcho has planted money in someone's lap. Take that for what you will.
Probably not the first time, right?
Yeah, and I'm sure it won't be the last if he's the Pillsbury Playboy. Elbow to the midsection. Overhand club. D-Money takes the upper hand again. Ow. It's a staple gun.
We're going from about
0 to 100 here pretty quick.
Right where the sun don't shine.
Well, if he staples his cheeks together, them Skittles will never come out.
Woo!
Honcho fights off the Stanley staple gun.
If he staples his mouth together, he might lose a bag of Skittles.
And this doesn't look good. And, well, you can use your imagination there, fans. Staple guns are...
Don't try this at home, right?
You know, I'm definitely not, and I don't know that... The men that paved the way for this great sport, like the Frank Gotchas and the Luthes, has ever thought about breaking out staple guns in the middle of a match. But I digress. And Money's got him down. That's the first pinfall attempt of this match.
That was a close call, too. He almost had it. I mean, how much pain and how much agony can you take in one match?
Honcho with a quick counter. How about the jawbreaker? Oh, clothesline.
Short clothesline.
I think the big man's through playing well.
Right with a back elbow.
Running elbow.
Sunset misses, and here we go. On that shoulder, airplane spin. Dive.
Oh! Follow away slam, and D-Money felt every bit of that.
Not like able to really cover it very well at that time.
Money got the shoulder up.
It's like Honcho's on instinct alone now.
Well, Honcho's taking quite a beating since these two men were in the ring earlier. But both men did. Truly, here comes Honcho using his assets to his advantage.
Right.
Speaking of which, D-Money's prone again, and Eddie Honcho's not going to let the opportunity pass. Straps down. Now, Jerry Lawler dropping a fist here.
Not ready for prime time here.
Honcho.
All righty, then.
I understand may have had Metzger before he got here. So hopefully he was able to
please pull the tights back up.
Hold the burrito in there long enough. Yes, tights need to be back up as well.
Oh!
Stomp to the gut for good measure.
If it didn't make you sick, that would definitely finish you off.
Honcho deceptively athletic. I hate to say that, but he is. He's going to go up and try to polish us off. He could be the brass champion, but that senton misses. Hard. Money hits him with that finishing maneuver. Drives the knee in the back of the head. And scores a quick pinfall.
The
all she wrote.
D-Money retains. Was that a match? You want to call it a match? It was something.
It was something. It was a sight to behold.
That is the best way I can describe it. And someone in the back will have to grab the nail of those pliers to remove the staples from various parts of the bodies. We'll be back, fans, in just a moment. The six-man tag team match that we've hyped up, the Dirt Road Dynasty against Terry Lawler, Jerry Nelms, and Robert Gibson. Stay tuned.
Another Hall of Famer coming up.
Fans, senior official Matthew Daniel is out here, and that's going to, I'm sure, draw the ire of the Dirt Road Dynasty. They've not been getting along, to say the very least, here in the last few months in GCW. But he's out here to ref this big six-man tag team attraction. As we're about to see Pat Roach, Sean Nelson, and Chris Nelms, the Dirt Road Dynasty, make their way out here in Buckhead. The match was made official last month. Robert Gibson was here, fans, just doing autographs, quite frankly, greeting the audience, and was pulled into this, and before we knew it, it was a six-man tag. Roach is our television champion. He'll be out here supporting the belt. As Bad Company creeps out across the Got to Be Your Own Event Center.
Some devious individuals at that company, for sure.
Sneaky, sneaky folks, and I'm sure there he is. That poor excuse for a human being, Benny Bacardi, leading the way. Crowd knows what's up. Chris Nelms in the front. TV champ Pat Roach in the middle and in the back. The Southern Outlaw, Sean Nelson. Nelson sporting his championship belt. He is the Southern Heritage Heavyweight Champion.
Something about Chris Nelms and legends. Who's he talking to? You?
Always. They outsmarted me last month. I'll have to give them credit on that. Nelms and Roach bought a ringside ticket when Sean Nelson squared off with Jacob Ashworth and helped him get the Duke. They're conniving. They are clever. Benny Bacardi, unfortunately tonight, seen and heard, normally just heard. He's actually in attendance with us here this evening in Buckhead. I'm sure the crowd's mood will flip here in just a moment when their opponents make their way out.
Await the opponents. This is going to be a battle for sure.
Benny Bacardi is already stirring the pot as only he can. Trying to get face to face with people, he has to have them sitting down. Mouth matches it for sure. And this is a big one, fans. We're about to have a Hall of Famer out here competing in the ring in this six-man tag team attraction.
And here they come.
But now hang on just a minute.
Well, that's not...
This is the Grapplers.
That's not them. What's going on?
Coming out to the Midnight Express theme, if I'm hearing that correctly. This is our GCW Tag Team Champions. I don't have this on my format.
Yes, there is, baby.
So I'm not sure what's up. There's no way for me. I've tried over the years, and thankfully they're wearing alternating colors tonight. I've tried to differentiate grappler one and grappler two, and it's no avail, so I just pick a number out of the number category. And of course, their third man in the faction, Xander Siebel, climbs into the ring as well. And a lot of personality. You talk about personality clashes, there's some personality clashes in the ring. And we haven't even gotten to the build opposition. What is going on here? Calling us a six-man tag team now. Bob's giving them individual introductions. It's only going to inflate their ego. The grappler working one of the ringside cameras in the ring. I don't even know what to say right now because I was told a different match was taking place. Head of the family. Too much credit.
They got titles all around.
There is so much gold in the ring that there's a glare coming off of it.
I checked it twice.
LaGrassi would be proud.
Where is our advertised opponents? Where is Jerry Nelm, Terry Lawler, and Robert Gibson at? We heard it made official last month. What is going on?
Not sure what's up here.
I'm the commissioner, and I wasn't even aware of this change, so I don't know what's up.
Well, there's the music.
Well, this may help.
Maybe we get some clarity here.
That's very familiar music.
You know, rock and roll is king.
And never dies, for that matter. Here we go. We got 9 minute ringside. I got to go find out what's going on, Ben. You hold it on the floor.
Yes, I'll try my best. So much pandemonium. You got men all around the place here. And so, Kevin is trying to make his way down, and we're going to see what exactly is taking place here. Three tag teams are out here. Benny Bacardi is out here. And Rock and Roll Express's own Robert Gibson is out here, and they're ready to take care of it. Those tag team champions hold those belts with great pride. Terry Lawler has that championship belt in his hand. He's got a lot of people eyeing him for that belt.
I want the answer to you. I want the answer to you. I've been gone.
Here,
that's right, you were all in
that bull hockey.
So, I'll tell you what, I'll
officially the world heavyweight of three teams.
Three tag teams.
A
three-way six-man. What kind of matchup is that going to be? He just made the match official. All three teams will be competing in a match. And you talked about pandemonium and excitement. What a match he just made official. It's all official. You did a great job, great decision making there.
Benny McCarty, for all of his knowledge, I guess was asleep at the wheel there and didn't even think this match had been made. Champ in the house. Jerry Dells was in that Dirt Road Dynasty until his brother turned on him, showing his true colors just a few months ago.
Nothing worse than a family feud. Robert Gibson.
Maybe we say more.
Half of the Rock and Roll Express.
Fans, there's going to be more moving parts here than in a cheap watch. We got nine men battling in three corners. It's a triple threat. Six man, so I guess it's a nine-man tag team. Now, this is confusing. One
so
fall.
So much going on.
Still
here.
Only one fall. No elimination to occur here. So these three teams.
May the best team win.
For sure. And the grapplers extended their respect to Gibson, Nelms, and Lawler, Dirt Road Dynasty, are not partaking.
They don't look too happy about the situation either.
I've said before that multi-man matches like this need two referees just to keep up with all the chicanery. Matthew Daniel is going to be earning his paycheck tonight.
It's hard enough to keep up between two wrestlers, unless that's nine.
Nine people duking it out here in Buckhead, all thanks to Veda, who gave me the okay I might have. This is her show.
All about her and Coco, that's for sure.
That's correct. Matthew Daniel, Keith Porter, hey, this is what we wanted. And we got it times three more men, so why not?
Go ahead and throw Benny in there, you'll have 9.5.
Well, that's being generous, maybe 9.25. So who's starting here? It's going to be Pat Roach and grappler number 467, I believe, in the ring right now. No one brought a can of Ray tonight, so I guess everyone kind of off the mark, but normally Ray all around ringside. Well, that's a man you really don't want to make mad at him, and Vito Roach is about 6'3", 290. Emulates Harley Race in just about every bit of his ring style.
He is old school to the core.
And talented.
Absolutely.
He'll be the TV champ.
And like you said, he's a big man.
Now just going back and forth with Robert Gibson. Well, I'm proud of Matthew Dale just for getting these men to neutral corners so we can start the match. We'll see how this plays out. Still got one more to go, by the way. Main event up next is the Anarchy Championship bout. Champion Nick Haley will be defending against Billy Buck.
Yeah, stay tuned because more action just keeps coming better and better.
Money fight to pro wrestling security.
You gotta have eyes in the back of your head in a match like this.
Well, when you got a mask on, it's gonna be even harder, but the grapplers, for all of their fun they like to have in the ring, are very talented themselves. Take them as seriously as do anything else. Finally, a lockup. And Roach, with the height and weight advantage, comes out on top. A quick reversal to a hammer lock. Grappler, what number did I say? 465? 6? 7? I'm not sure. It's one of the grapplers.
Get
good escape there and maintains that standing wrist lock, the grappler.
Put your entire arm in a bind.
Applying the pressure now, full arm twist. Oh, got it! Into an upper hammer lock, and he's locking him down now. Trying to control his man. Who will keep the control in this match? Ah, referee trying to check a hair pull and a little dot to the eye.
Not an open socket there, and tags in Chris Nels. Former television champion here in GCW, former tag team champion with his brother, who we already mentioned. Felt the sheer moment of betrayal just a few months ago. Moxley's popped back up here ringside to collect the various gimmicks, as we say, to clean off the ring apron, belts, jackets, appendages. That was a tag, wasn't it? It was. Here comes Roach in on the exchange. John Nelson was illegally choking again. As I said, how do you keep order with nine people in there? Hard to do.
Now it returns the favor with the elbow there.
And grappler number 464 has tagged in.
What's good for the dudes is good for the gander.
Absolutely. He locks up with the big man. John Nelson, feeling one of the dirt road guys that has not been in yet. Pop has a lot of power behind it. As they continue to work in a neutral corner. Cut off the green. Nelson in now for the first time. Can't believe it.
Arm lifts him across. Oh, he fell hard.
Man, what a whip that was. Nelson coming in hot.
No forgiveness with that turnbuckle.
Grappler caught off guard. Three six-man quote-unquote teams. Out here in our semi-main event. Grappler's back on top here. That's him with a thrust. And a one count.
Just as we predicted, the referee has got his work cut out.
Harry Lawler's in for the first time. How about the rock and roll handkerchiefs on the kick pads of Terry Lawler?
A little homage there.
He's excited as anyone in attendance tonight to be tagging with Robert Gibson. Talk about Georgia wrestling legends here, Ben. This guy has done it all in this state.
He really has. And he's not an old man, but he's been around a long time.
Tell me.
I remember when he was the Jailhouse Rocker.
How about that? You know, he went back to that a few years ago during his, you know, first retirement tour. We'll see if he has another one in his back pocket sometime. Told me in intermission that he'll be turning 55 soon. I just have a hard time believing that. He still moves around like a pup.
Still in phenomenal shape for a man.
Best shape he's probably been in his career, honestly, these last couple of years.
Absolutely.
And now going back and forth
takedown
with Xander Seabolt.
And trying to control that arm. And if he's controlling that arm, he's got him down good. Get those shoulders ever so close, dangerously close to getting pinned.
And rolls through and gets the tag on the grappler. He's got a pinfall more or less on Lawler here, but armbar is broken. Lawler trying to get his bearings about him. I think he's probably there. Grappler 467 is tagged back in. Well, we got some pleasantries here in the early going. I have a feeling that's not going to last. Test of strength. Coming out on top. Tag to Jerry Nell's blind tag. I don't know if the grappler is ready for it. He's not. Well, each of these teams working together like cohesive units, to say the least. Nell's another southpaw in the ring, along with that mysterious blue-suited grappler. Headbutt. Nell's rocked. Slams his head to the turnbuckle. Now the grappler's in there. Now we got a lefty-lefty matchup. And we ain't talking baseball.
Not at all. Any team could win this match.
Get the head of steam, and oh, he did not land in a favorable fashion.
Upside down.
And an octave higher in the shower tonight, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
Yow.
Now, I and his brother over there, a little animosity going on.
Well, how can there not be? I mean, you gotta understand Jerry Nelms' frustration. He was loyal to these guys forever, including his brother. I mean, his brother, he grew up with him. And he got poked in the back a few months ago. I don't blame him one bit.
You can't trust him at all.
And just to point this out, Jerry Nelms is also still donning the handkerchiefs around the knee pads as well.
Being supportive of rock and roll tonight.
Grappler may be hurt here. No, he's not. Oh, baby.
Yeah, he went in and he got him that time.
I got to say, Matthew Daniel missed that. We all saw it here at home, but that's one way to get the upper hand. Grappler playing possum there for a moment. Had everyone in attendance a little concerned.
Tag is Mary
Chris Delms. Here we go.
Brother versus brother.
We saw a little bit. We got a sample of this a month or two ago. We need to see more of it. We're getting it for a moment.
Blood versus blood. Tag is made.
Of course, Chris Delms tags right back out. It's a cheap shot or two in. Nelson and Jerry Nelms going at it. Big clothesline. Holy cow. Got to turn him inside out. Lackadaisical pin there, Ben. He might have just been toying with him. Snap suplex.
Snapped him hard, too.
Reeling on the back of his head here. Here comes the big man, Pat Roach.
Hard fist to the head.
There is one positive to having 9 men in this match. We don't have to hear Benny McCarty as much. He's still at ringside, but he's being silenced, thank goodness. Snapmare takeover. And that is a lot of weight you're putting on in addition to being a reverse chiplock.
Yes, it is.
Laying that almost 300-pound frame across Jerry Nelms. Now it switches to an overhand wrist lock.
Putting the pressure now, and he got him down on the mat.
He's in anguish.
Stomps him right to the ribcage there.
Mercy.
Jerry now really in no man's land over there as they keep making those frequent tags in and out. It's a dangerous place to be.
This whole match is a dangerous place to be. There's just too many moving parts, but hey, this is what the crowd wanted, what Beta wanted.
Now look, no one there for the tag. He's going to have to find his own buddies over there.
Well, that's interesting to me. The grapplers seem to be almost, I won't say working with them, but was certainly on friendly terms, and they're just didn't want to tag in at all. That's strange. Will they take the tag from Nelson? I guess not, because he's going to dump Jerry Nelms to the floor.
And here comes Robert Gibson.
Gibson's not been in yet, I might
add. They won't let him in.
The grapplers are going to...
Meanwhile, they're double teaming here on the floor.
Terry Lawler's got a chair. Tempers are flaring here at Buckhead.
Well, now attack on the floor continues. Referee distracted by Terry, who's trying to fight fire with fire. Meanwhile, the double teaming continues.
Terry Nell's getting pulled up here. Double suplex!
And he got that hard.
Baby. I'll break a cockage in a heartbeat. Not going for the cover here, though. They just want to administer punishment to Jerry Nelms. And a side slam. Nelms is writhing in pain on the mat. Pat Rose doing whatever he darn well pleases right now with his former Dirt Road Dynasty partner. Terry Lawler's seen enough, but it's only a temporary reprieve. There was no tag. You saw that, Ben. He just stuck in.
Full advantage there. So sneaky. So devious.
Plants him with that body slam. Second rope. He won't go all the way upstairs, I don't believe. He doesn't.
Oh!
And misses the elbow.
Nobody's home.
Boy, might have tweaked the knee. And in comes Robert Gibson.
Finally, the Rock and Roll Express is here.
And he's a house of fire. He almost hit the ref.
He had a step. Look out. Talked about confusion.
Cut down the hatches. We're going to get our head on a swivel again here, Ben.
It's hard to keep up with what's what. Even the wrestlers have a hard time keeping up.
And a meeting of the minds here. Nels and Gibson both meet up center ring. Clothesline misses. And the grappler clotheslines Nels. Robert Gibson whips him in.
In the midsection. Sunset flip. He's got it.
Sunset flip. Two. Holds him down. They've got it.
He got a winner.
That quick. It is over. Jerry Nels, Robert Gibson, and Terry Lawler prevail. And if I heard that correctly, we've got new six-man tag team champions.
It looks like we do. And what a team to have the titles.
Grapplers weren't even involved in the outcome, and they have lost their championships. It's over.
New champions are here at Bay.
How about that?
What a matchup right here for you to see on YouTube.
And you!
And the new champions are here, and the fans can be happy.
Yes.
Well, he's being called over now. Let's see what he's got to say.
I don't know what all this is. They've got a belt. I don't know what it's about. Here's the deal. We signed a contract for this match to be between us and the number of dynasty. Anyway, as much as I respect you, we're not involved in that contract. So basically,
complaining that this wasn't me. And we got pandemonium and excitement still going on. With a six-man tag belt. Robert Gibson saying, oh, it's fair.
You asked, it was a call, it was a call to you, to make it fair. We look for you. We're now, on the last night.
I can beat you any day.
And right now, if anyone else is in your career, and let them get into your notes,
right now for these belts, he said to make it fair.
Will they agree? I know Robert Gibson's always been a fighting champion. I know Terry Lawler has a heart of gold and backs down from no one. And Jerry Nims is running along with him. Dirt Road Dynasty has exited. So now we have two teams in the ring. Gibson says, as far as he's concerned, they are the rightful owners of the tag team championship. They're asking the fans. They want to see it. There's a lot going on here. The belts with it. Stole the tag team belts. Talked about sore losers. The champions are Robert Gibson. A match last month with Rock and Roll, Robert Gibson, Jerry Nims, and Terry Lawler getting that match against the Grapplers and Sebo for the tag team belts that they just won.
Yeah.
six man next month, right here, for Georgia Championship Wrestling to find out who will leave with those belts with the title.
First of all, I'm going to go to the agent. What are you talking about?
Checking the calendar to make sure everyone's available. You never know what's going to happen. Georgia Championship Wrestling.
I wouldn't know where I'm at, maybe.
Now, as Kevin's going back to the back, trying to see can they get this match made for next month at Georgia Championship Wrestling. We'll have more action coming up and more information for you right after this.
Main event time, if we're back with you from Buckhead. Kevin Hendry, GCW Commissioner, trying to gather my bearings, so to speak, as we look to finish out tonight's show on a high note, to say the very least. Wow, what a mess. Tried to go back and find the grapplers. They were on higher ground, as I predicted. I figured they were in another zip code by now, and they are. And here comes Billy Buck, the challenger for the Anarchy Heavyweight title.
And what a challenger he will be. Main event anywhere in Georgia, right here, two of the top
guys.
Yes,
indeed. There's a reason we held this one for last. Hey, it's a confusing situation with that six-man tag team title.
Really
right is. Now, as it stands, though, we're going to have that rematch next month, and that way everybody can be fresh as daisies, as they say. However, the grapplers have got to come back with those championship belts in tow, or they won't be the champions. They're not just going to be the champions just because they hold the titles. So if they don't show back up with the belts next month like they're supposed to, and I'll have to get a hold of them later to make sure they do that.
You might have to get law enforcement involved if you have to.
I mean, may have to go to that extreme, but I'll say this. If we have to go to that extreme, there will be no champions because those three were thrust into this.
Right.
The contract was for a different match. That other contract was signed, but it wasn't for the titles. But the grapplers were not involved.
Very sticky situation.
We just hope you'll join us May 18th for our next show here in Buckhead to see how it all turns out.
But you can't miss because you have to do the resolution.
Absolutely. And here comes Nick Halen. Making his way out.
We got champions everywhere. It's like a night of champions.
The Big Show fans, and it's all for Veda and Coco.
Glad to have them still with us. A miracle that they're here.
Yes.
And we're going to show support to the fans that support us, not just here, but all over Georgia.
Well, Halen's having a ringside chat with Ashley, another one of our dedicated fans. I gave her a birthday cake the other night. That was a warm moment to see.
Yeah.
Now Halen chats over. He'll make his way around ringside. Billy Buck is already in the ring. Halen also won the championship from Jeter way back in September at Hardcore Hell in Kent.
Talk about big man.
No joke. Well, it came a huge disadvantage to pick up the championship. Southern Fried represented tonight here as well. How about that?
crazy. They're from all over. Everyone's pitching in trying to help out.
And now the champion. He hails from Athens, Georgia. He weighed in at 210 pounds. He has a reigning Mad Army heavyweight champion, the Fury Breaker, Nick Haven!
Up the road, Athens, Georgia. We're about 30 minutes away from the capital of the Georgia Bulldogs, of course. The ancient city itself. Nick Haven and Billy Buck are set to duke it out here with the Anarchy title on the line. A lot of prestige in this state for this championship belt.
Beautiful belt for sure. A lot of prestige coming from this title.
And the official Matthew Daniel signed this one. And there's the bell. It's been underway. On the Buck on the same page.
Well, that's nice.
Got a handshake, gentleman's handshake.
Well, see how long that lasts, right?
What's the over under? I got 5 minutes.
Maybe. Tempers don't flare too fast.
Lock up, quick flip. And Buck stand off.
A lot of respect, you can see the winners today.
Oh, this isn't the first time each of them have met. They've duped it out many times before across the state.
Lock up now. No, no, no. I'm trying to take down.
And right back. Hey, what were we said all night? Well, it's good for the goose, good for the gander, right?
That's right. Turnabout is fair play.
You beat me to it. There you go.
Put the worst right in your mouth.
Yes, you
did.
You
must be doing the same thing for a long time. Locked up again. Full arm twist, standard wrist lock. And a reverse on the wrist lock. And another reversal. And another.
And a reversal. And a reversal.
And
oh, sorry.
Bull drives that shoulder in, trying to pull that arm right out of the socket.
Absolutely.
Full arm twist, standard wrist lock. Drops an elbow with the arm.
And hey, just because Billy Buck got the advantage right now, I don't know if it's going to last, as you can see. These men are pretty evenly matched.
They're both into the winner, that's for sure. And Batsman in the corner, we get a clean break, we'll see.
Big chop.
Boy, I think you were right. It was under 5 minutes.
Yes, it definitely was.
Oh! Again, turnabout.
Buck can deliver a smack across the chest. I dare say he's got the advantage right now on that because he has a shirt on. Allen drops him down with a tackle. Jumps over.
Good, they're behind. Flips him around.
Scoop slam.
Drops an elbow, but nobody there.
Haven took a little too long to drop that elbow and paid for it.
Right back to that headlock.
Right back to the headlock. Nobody's in a hurry here. Don't want to make any mistakes in this championship bout. Now Buck tackles Haven.
Shoulder tackle down. Rides him, man. Rolls him up backwards.
Two count. Wow, what a veteran maneuver there by Buck.
Hip toss takedown. Good kick off. Right back to his feet and snaps him over. Good kick.
No man can get anywhere in this.
These two men are really showing why they are both champions.
Top dogs in their promotion.
This should be a dream match because you don't get to see these cross promotion matches all the time.
Oh yeah, throwback. You haven't seen them in probably what, 30, 40 years?
Right.
In the early 80s, you still had back in the Harley race duking it out some stupid times.
Oh yeah.
Those days are long gone, my friend. Except for tonight.
I saw Ric Flair and Bob Backlund at the Omni in Atlanta.
Oh wow. That'd be a classic. Flips him up over the top rope, speaking of Ric Flair. And out to the floor goes Billy Buck. Boy, he hit hard. Matthew Daniel checking on him. He must be okay. Daniel slides back into the ring. Haven will meet.
Meanwhile, the referee is counting. Yeah. Talking about front row. worth the price of the mission to come back to your lap. You don't get that in WWE.
Definitely not.
Only here shows like Georgia Championship Wrestling bringing right to your face.
These two men still battling.
Head first right into that heartache.
Where's Halen going? Oh, he's going to jab him right in the face. Short poke right there in front of Vader. How about that? Kick out of him.
He's in the hot seat.
She's been in the hot seat most of the night. Big Money had to have a sit down with her earlier tonight. Go back into the ring. Well, Halen has finally taken the advantage of this match. I didn't know if that was going to happen anytime soon. It was part of the improved at one time with Adrian Hawkins. Broken out here at the top of the pack. That headbutt rocks Halen.
Look, he's still in it, though.
Both men back to exchanging. Lefts, rights, kicks, chops.
Just as tough.
Kitchen sinks, Ford Pintos,
whatever
you name it.
Grab,
that's right. Throws him across, Buck beats him with a clothesline. And there's a big elbow.
Right on top of the head, another elbow.
Dusty Rhodes will be proud of those two bionic elbows. Side slam into a backbreaker.
Wow.
Seen that in a long time. Going to rush a leg sweep. How about that?
That covers him, puts the leg.
Two count.
Sunday action here on Georgia Championship Wrestling fans. You gotta come out and see it live. You gotta be here in person. Really super excited, but thanks for watching on YouTube. We appreciate you watching.
See us live for a taping fans. We're normally here only third or fourth Saturday of the month, but we have social media to keep you posted as well on when our next show is. And currently it's May 18th when you're watching this in real time. Halen takes back over with a clothesline. Atomic drop. And now the reversal coming.
Got him without time to drop.
And Buck is stunned in more ways than one. Versus the whip.
Oh!
And lands a big forearm. Both men down.
And the count's on for both men. Who's got the determination, the drive enough to keep going in this match? It's still any man's game.
Wow, nip up by Nick Halen. He's still got plenty of gas in the tank. Big foot across Billy Buck. Goes outside. Maybe upstairs.
Climbing that top ring rope on that. He can almost reach the ceiling.
And Buck caught it. Halen took a little time jawing at the crowd, and that was costly.
Can't take your eye off the ball, that's for sure.
Now let's see what Buck's going to do here as he climbs upstairs with him. Oh, this
taking
is not going to do it.
That's a long way down right there.
All the way to the T-top of the elevator.
Oh, man.
Is he going for the super, super flex? He is.
Oh,
and
man,
Halen's hooked.
Got it!
And I am shocked the ring held up. Holy tamale.
It sure left the floor, that's for sure.
That's over 400 pounds of mass falling for about 10 to 12 feet in the air.
I think that moved our table.
Jeez. If either man gets up from that devastating superplex, I'll be shocked. Title's up for grabs. That may channel their energy, though.
That's what makes you keep going.
Both men taking well-deserved breathers, and quite frankly, may just be trying to catch their breath after that.
You know, a championship can separate the men from the boys. What can you do? What's that intestinal fortitude? Who's got the most?
Able to dig deep in these big match situations, and this is as big as it gets here in GCW.
Fans are watching intently. Like we say, if you go either way, both men slowly moving to their feet.
And speaking of either way, the crowd's kind of split too. I'd say about 50-50 here. Both combatants have their fans and their...
I think they're just really appreciating what they're seeing. Two phenomenal athletes.
And we're right back to a battle again, back and forth.
Slugfest now.
Oh, man, what a right hand by Halen. Holy cow.
That hurt his hand.
Rock answers back with one that rocks both men down to the knee. This far into a ballot, punch like that takes one out of both of them. Buck held on. Running DDT. Halen's out. Not for long enough. Man. 2 9/10 on that pinfall attempt. And you see Billy Buck slowly climbing back up to his feet. Let's see if he gets the crowd support. He's going to call in the crowd getting behind him. Halen is not getting up, by the way, so Billy Buck can take all night if he wants to measure him. Halen now showing some signs of life. He uses the ropes just to get up on his feet, though. Super kick. It's blocked.
Oh!
Halen drops him. Buck's not moving. One, two, and a two count.
So close, but so far away.
Boy, these two men are really putting a lot of prestige for this crowd tonight, showing you, as we've said already through this match, why this championship is so important.
Both men just going through the motions, trying to get the upper hand, get back up to the feet, and it's hard to do. They've been in a terrific battle. Almost pulls him up, uppercut, with all the strength he has left.
Halen did look like he had a second win there for a moment, as did Buck, but I think those wins are long gone now.
And every swing takes a little bit more out of him.
Irish whip, and referee Matthew Daniel almost got caught in the line of fire there. Boy, he stepped out of the way at the last second. Hard Irish whip. And
reversal.
A reversal, and he's stuck the other way that time. Oh, no.
And he's doubled over now.
Daniel took a hard fall.
Out of the way. Oh.
Super kick. Hooks the leg. Matthew Daniel.
Referee is still doubled over.
Do we have anybody else in the back that can come out and make the count? Maybe not. Billy Buck might have won the championship right there.
He was the champion if the ref had been lined up.
Matthew Daniel was caught in the wrong place at the wrong time, man.
He tried to move. He had previously moved. This match is just a open book.
It's hard to predict what's going to happen. Daniels had a long night. Already had to rip that nine-man matchup we had earlier. Nick Halen is out. He's having to pick up dead weight right now. Is Billy Buck. Going for small packages.
He's got it.
And a reversal one. And another reversal one. And two. And that's
so close.
Still no winner yet.
That's a close line. Close him up. He almost had a handful of times.
Now Billy Buck is going to roll him up and get two. What in the world?
These two guys are fighting fire with fire at every turn.
They're going for a backslide.
He's hooked it. He's got it. Shoulders down. One.
Halen's loose.
And lots of Billy Buck from backslide.
My goodness.
Swings and misses. Caught him in midair.
Oh, how about a sit-out powerbomb?
Never seen.
Oh, man, that's not going to be all.
I thought he had it.
Holy tamale.
Bravo for some well-done wrestling action right here.
Back and forth.
You're watching the Georgia Championship Wrestling, but this is an all-important championship match. I'll tell you what, the Anarchy Championship's on the line. You don't think the belt is important? Watch what these two have put into this match.
Now Buck's going to measure, try that super kick again. He got caught a moment ago. He might have it this time. Halen's a lot worse for the wear than he was the first time around.
He's got that stomp going.
And he caught him again. Grabs the leg over the ropes. Swinging net breaker.
That just put him out right there, but he's not done.
He knows he's got to do more than that. Going all the way up, going for that big elbow.
If you want the big W, you got to put in a little bit extra time.
Halen can flat out deliver an elbow, and he nailed it there.
He got it.
Buck is prone. Buck is out, I believe. That's all.
And that's it. What a matchup that was.
Wow, what a main event here at Buckhead. Halen wins Donnybrook with Billy Buck.
What a matchup. Unforgettable action.
Hey, fans,
I enjoyed working with you tonight.
And my pleasure, Ben. It's been a fun show to call tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, give these guys a
we will see you down the road.
Nice round of applause for both these men from our ring announcer, Pops. We appreciate you all joining us tonight here in Buckhead. It's been my pleasure to work with Master. We'll see you guys next month.
Goodbye, everybody.
Here in GCW.